today now. Okay, this is the project meeting for the two projects which we are discussing today. That is project serial number 13 and 14. And today we are talking about this one. We are going to make a dot matrix over here by using some SMD LEDs. And the file has been shared with you. That is the SMD LED dot matrix projects.pdf. I hope everyone has gone through this one. I am sharing my screen as well now, so everyone can have a look on this one. Okay, so now if I go towards the file of it, I hope everyone has gone through this text detail over here. SMD LEDs, since there are two projects I am discussing at present, one is 1206, the other one is 0805. These are two SMD LED size, and SMDs also come in the same size just like resistors or diodes or anything. So the sizes are 1206, as you all know, and 0805. We have used a lot of resistances in SMD assignments up till now. So what you are going to do, you are actually going to make a dot matrix yourself. Up till now, what you have been doing up till now in this overall lab over here was this, that you had a yellow dot matrix, something like this over here, as you can see over here. And this was 8 LEDs cross 8 LEDs, this means 64 LEDs arranged over here in some row or column combination. And this yellow dot matrix specifically was actually column arranged over here. By column arranged, I actually mean, if I go towards the circuit diagram of this yellow dot matrix, sorry about this. So if you see this yellow dot matrix over here, the pin number 1, pin number 16, pin number 2, pin number 14, 4, 12, 6, 10, and 8, they are actually having the columns connected over here. So column number 1 is in pin number 16. So this dot matrix which you are seeing, the yellow dot matrix which we have used up till now, this is column arranged. Now this can be row arranged also. Just what you have to do, you have to change the direction of these LEDs. And I hope I don't need to actually tell that this, where my cursor is at present, this is the anode and this is the cathode. So instead of having the anode connected with the columns over there, you can make it vice versa, and then it will be row wise arranged. So whatever dot matrix you have to make today over here in this experiment, the project over here, this has to be row arranged over here. And since there are two projects over here, one is 1206, the other one is 0805 size over there. The 1206 size is approximately 3.2 mm is the, you can call it the length, cross 1.5 mm, and 1.1 mm is the height of it. Just a comparison is also given over here in this picture, as you can see the PDF file also. So you can see the 1206 and 805. 1206 is something like a rectangle with some X and 2X, which means that 1.5 mm is the width, 3.2 mm is the length of it. So when you are having this 1206 or 0805, 0805 has a size of 2 cross 1.25, as you can see over here. So the main objective of this is this, that you have to make a PCB. The sizes are written over here. If you are working on the 0805 size, then the size of the PCB has to be 40 mm cross 40 mm. This is the maximum size. You can't go beyond this thing. And if you are working on 1206 size, which is certainly larger, since 1206, if I scroll back over here, this is having a 3.2 mm cross 1.5 mm. So if 3.2 mm is there and you have to arrange 8 LEDs over there, so the spacing between each LEDs should be something like this. As you can see over here, I have written in the PDF file that spacing for 0805 LEDs, it has to be 2 mm, and spacing for 1206 LED has to be 3.2 mm. Now if you see closely over here, I don't know why the voice is not clear. Don't worry, it's being recorded. I guess this must be some error at your end, hopefully, because up till now, I guess just only 7 participants are there. No one has actually said anything about it. Don't worry, this is being recorded, so I will just away upload this after this session is over. Okay, coming back to this one, so when you are having this arranged 8 cross 8 LEDs, as you can see over here, now it's totally up to you. You arrange them in this formation or the other way around, it's totally up to you. But just, it should be clear. Bilal, can you hear me? I hope so. It should be very clear, I guess. I have nothing changed on my side at least. Bilal, I still can't hear any word from you. I don't know why. It's lagging. Maybe just because it's like 6 p.m. in the evening, maybe load is quite much, but I don't think so. My internet is working fine until now. Okay, let's see. Let's see. Just wait for like 1-2 minutes more, and if it is, if it continues to go like this, then certainly we can have you can go through the recording. Don't worry on this one. I have given you the PDF file, and PDF file is still enough over there for whatever data is given over here. So just let me go through it, and we'll have the recording over. Okay, so as you can see over here, the LEDs are arranged in the center of this PCB, and they are arranged certainly in some certain formation over here. So if you are using 0805 LED, then the spacing between each LED has to be 2 mm. So which means that if this is where my mouse or cursor is at present, so when the next LED just to the right of it, the distance between them should be 2 mm, and then the distance down below, other one should also be 2 mm. So the symmetry should be maintained. Actually, the point of actually giving this dimension of 2 mm and 3.2 mm is this, that the symmetry should be maintained, and 8x8 matrix is formed in the center of this PCB. Now the PCB, as you can see over here in the PDF file over here, is this, that you have to only place three components on the top layer of the PCB. By placing the components mean that they are physically present. They will be, since this is the top layer, and the SMD LEDs which you are going to use in this case, they are going to be soldered on the top. So certainly this means there will be some tracks on the top layer as well, but there will be two female headers. One will be 8-pin male header here on this side on the extreme left, as you can see, which is ULN2803 driving, and then you have an 8-pin male header over here for the transistor based connection or driving of the LED matrix, which is actually the power. And then you have a VCC and ground connection, just like a block connector over here. So if you are working on a 0805 size over here, then you have something like 40 mm cross 40 mm, and if you are working at 1206, then you have 60 mm cross 60 mm is the size of your PCB. Now the resistances calculation and all that will still is not an issue over here, because what I am talking about here is this, that you are actually implementing the same circuitry over here. So now what you have to do, if you have seen the yellow dot matrix experiment number 3, you are actually implementing now the whole same thing. The only thing change is this, that this time you are not using a yellow dot matrix. This time you are going to connect your own dot matrix over here, and you are going to connect the column 1 directly with the connector over here of this 2SA684, but this is going to be SMD, so 2SA684 will be changed to BC869, and then 2N93904 is going to be changed to the SMD packaging of this one. And certainly these resistances, which are 1 kilo ohms, 470 ohms and 4.7K, they are going to be of size 0805. This is very important, that these three resistances, 1 kilo ohms, 470 ohms and 4.7K, they are going to be of the smaller size 0805. Then this 10 ohm resistance and this resistance, which will be changed when we will be soldering it, they are going to be of 1210 size. This is very important. 10 ohms and this resistance, which is connected with the ULN, again ULN2803 AIC, which you are going to use over here, is going to be the SMD packaging of this one. So just you are going to put the male header here. No, this dip switch is not required. No dip switch is required over here. Just an 8-pin male header, just like the PDF file I have given you. And then you have to arrange all the. One thing very important when you will be soldering it, especially when you will be soldering it, we will have this one in the university over here. But when you are going to place them on the PCB, you have to be very careful that the anodes are combined with the rows over there, and the cathodes are combined over there. So you can use the footprint of a 0805 over there, no harm in that. But and you can use the 1206 over here for the 1206 size SMD over here on this over here. PCB top layer. Now one thing very important, that is the bottom layer of the PCBs will have all the SMD transistors, resistors, regulators, that is the regulator 7 at M05, which will be actually converting the input VCC and ground into the 5 volts, and then the IC is SMD. So I guess 60 mm cross 60 mm, not that small, not that big over here. Everything can be arranged. This is just like one UL2803 and 8 transistor pairs like this that we have done just now. This 8 transistor pairs in SMD on the back side. So the front side of your PCB is only going to have the LEDs arranged, certainly with some top layer tracks over there, because the SMD LED is soldered on the top side. And then certainly you have the male header over here, this black color on the left side and the black color on the right side over there. And then there is just a VCC and ground connection over there. Just adhere to the limits that have been given to you, and if somehow there is some problem with the limits or whatever, you can talk to me or Sir Bilal on this point. But I have taken the calculations in consideration, and that's why I've given the size of 40 mm cross 40 mm and the 60 cross 60 mm. So it should not be that much difficult to actually arrange on the back side. Everything, there will be vias, a lot of vias over here from the top layer to the bottom layer, so don't worry on that one. It's a two-layer PCB, so nothing is going to be changed over here. So just a reminder over here, all the resistances, if I hope everyone can see this screen over here. So if you are talking about this resistance over here, so 1 kilo ohm, 470 ohm and 4.7K, so all of these 1K, 470 ohms and 4.7K, they all are going to be 0805 size SMD resistances, and the 10 ohms plus the ULN resistance, that will be certainly something different, not the same value as the yellow dot matrix, that is going to be 1210 size. And then the regulator which you are using over here, that is 78M05. The package is available on my website also, and Sir Bilal given link also. So this is the regulator, and this again is an SMD regulator that you are actually using over there. And then the remaining portion is the very same. So this is very important that you adhere to this one. The only thing very important is actually the how you actually make this visible. So all the 8 cross 8 64 LEDs are present over here. So you are going to use, I guess the project is actually something that one group has to use the red one, the other one has to use the green one. So certainly there will be some resistance change that is connected with the ULN, otherwise the size only difference is there. So please, any questions regarding this, you can write down in the conversation window, and I can answer them just now. Please. Still just 8 students are here, so this means half of them are not here. So something good. Anyway, any questions regarding this one? It's not that easy, but don't worry, since this is just the design phase. When the soldering will be done, we will do this in the university. We are giving you 1 week's time for this project over here. Still, this is not the final one. So when you are going to bring this in the next week, you are going to bring your design. We are going to point out the problems at that time, and then we will give you like 2-3 days more, and then we will finish our design much before the university opens, and then we will give this design to some Halroth person. I will give that list to you, so whoever is suitable for you, you can get your PCB done from there. And then when the university opens, I will personally try to give one project per each group, maybe a part of it to be soldering by my own hand, so everyone has an idea how to do it. So it's relatively not that easy, let me tell you. If I don't have actually the picture of the last year project of the same cater, but it to have all the LEDs in symmetry and a straight line and to solder them, a little difficult. So don't worry, with your some effort and some skills, we can do this. So it's not that difficult. Gee, any more questions? The project is very easy, so I guess it's nothing something out of the box or something. Whatever you have done up till now, it's the very same circuit, but how you are going to arrange it and how you are going to manage it, that's actually the most important thing over here. So this is very important that your symmetry of the whole PCB, how you are going to arrange all your transistors, since there will be 16 transistors and like 64 resistors over here, and then one IC at the back of this PCB, and the size is very constrained, so it will be a little jam-packed, but overall the look of this is going to be very good. So I hope everyone can do this thing very easily. Gee, any questions, Vita? We still have like 5-6 minutes left for this one. So I hope so, everyone of each group, since there are 16 students here, let me just so I hope there are 16 students here, so out of 16 still 8 are here, so I expect at least one student from each group is here. But if any group is not represented over here, sorry, so you can have just seen the recording, and I hope everyone can have a look what is to be done in this project. But please, one thing very important, since this question has been asked again and again, that you have to submit only one design per each group. This is not like you are going to submit two designs from each group. This is going to be one design. You are far apart from each other, but maybe one student can actually have the nets defined and the other one can actually arrange it, and the next one, the same one, can actually do the auto routing and then some contention removing or whatever. So I guess that's why we have actually made it two students per each group. So the cost which is going to be done on the PCB designing and the LEDs which have to be bought, because an SMD LED of 0805 size or 1206 size, I guess it's going to be something like 4 or 5 rupees per. So some the cost can be shared between two students. So that's why the PCB cost and the equipment cost can be shared. And one thing very important, if your PCB and the project is well and good designed, it's running, soldered beautifully, and it's running, then certainly we can take some of your previous marks which we have attained in your assignment or whatever, so we can change something. But again, on the condition that your project is something very good and out of the box, and it stands out in all of the projects submitted in this semester. So please put in effort in this. That's why we are doing this sessions over here, so that the projects can be of some good caliber and you can learn the skills required over here. The meaning of actually having all this 23 different projects over here is this, that you can actually learn the skills that will be required for you to actually make the PCBs in your next 3 years to come on, or maybe even after your graduation if you are working somewhere else. Maybe as a PCB designer, or maybe as an electronic expert or something. Gee, any questions? So this means that there is no question. Okay, so I guess this is then enough over here. I can just 8 people are here. Please remind these other 8 people, if you have a contact with them, that the attendance is very important. You have missed this week's main introductory meeting. The next week meeting, maybe not at the very same time, but we will have a meeting on your request. And on the submission of all your projects, whatever you have done, Sir Bilal will make the link available for you. And one thing very important, again, please no copying. You have approximately like some 10 students over here. I have the list over here with me. These are the 10 students over here. 16 students, which are 8 groups over here, which are working in the 4 sections over here. And these are 8 groups. Please do not copy any design. Okay, it's very easy to catch over here, even the next name are same or something like this can happen, and then straight away, and having a copy mark on your project means a straight F in this lab. So I hope this is all over here. I have downloaded the attendance, So if you have any questions apart from this one, so I hope the PDF file given to you is enough for it, and you can do the work very easily on this one. So I am just ending this meeting now. So I hope.